What does Jude 1:4 says about grace? Because he does not understand.
For there are certain men crept in unawares, who were before of old ordained to this condemnation, ungodly men, turning the grace of our God into lasciviousness, and denying the holy, take note of that word, denying the holy Lord. These are people that have made up their minds to reject the sacrifice of Christ. They are among us, but they don't believe in the death of Christ. He's talking about Antichrist. Antichrist is a spirit, it's not a person. Antichrist is a doctrine. Antichrist is a teaching that rejects the humanity and the deity of Christ. That's Antichrist. Any church that does not teach that Jesus came in the flesh is Antichrist. I mean, it's clear in scripture. And let me shock you a little. Maybe in the next school of ministry we'll deal with that. The day of the rapture is the end of the time. There is nothing like rapture, then great tribulation. The day rapture happens, the end of the world, everything will finish at the same time. There's nothing like, if you don't repent, what to do after the rapture? There's nothing like that. Rapture, as we live, the world closes. That's the end of the world. That's the end of the world. What gives you an impression that there will be another continuation is the mentality that is sold to you in Left Behind and all those movies, that after the church left, then a world ruler came out, conquered America, conquered Europe, conquered here, and became the world ruler and ruled for a long time. And anybody that believed in Christ, they gave them 666, bam, bam, bam. Why is there 666 in Revelation? It is not literal. The 666 in Revelation is metaphorical. The book of Revelation was written with metaphorical language. Bring another question.
Somebody watching somewhere now sending this question.
Yeah.
The Matthew chapter 5:17.
Yes.
And
put it up. Put it up.
5:17, 18 and 19.
Put it up. Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill. What does it mean to fulfill? I am come to fulfill the demands. The demands of the law, the requirements of the law that you cannot fulfill, I have come to fulfill it. Now, when he fulfilled the requirement, what did he do? He abolished. I mean, it's so clear. Turn your heart from Moses, you will understand what I'm teaching. Because as long as your heart is with Moses, you can't see what I'm teaching. It has to turn from Moses to the Lord. Then the veil is taken. And only Jesus can fulfill the law. Nobody else. Nobody else. And he fulfilled it. That is why he redeemed us. He fulfilled it. That is why we have the adoption of children. And that is why now he has set forth the spirit of his son into our hearts. And what is that spirit? Crying, Abba Father. Stand, let's close.